a party every week, baby.
Call me, check it out.
That's right, I'm in the house.
He's gonna shake it up and change it.
Just shake it up.
Take it all and rearrange it.
Just a little bit.
Got a new plan.
Hey, welcome to the show, Palmer.
I'm Zoe.
I'm Michael.
Santa Annie.
And today is Monday, December 5th, and here's the news.
Here are the Christmas dress days. Today is Baby It's Cold Outside, which is winter wear. You can wear sweaters, scarves, or boots.
Thursday is Oh What Fun. Dress like your favorite Christmas character from a movie, cartoon, or storybook.
Friday is Candy Cane Wishes. It's all out red and white.
DCPL will be holding a book swap party for teens today. Teens can bring in books in good condition that they have already read and exchange them for books from other attendees. The library will also have copies of some popular YA novels on hand for those who would like to participate in the swap but don't have books of their own to share.
Stop by the table in the lobby at lunch to vote for the best No Shave November beard.
Stay tuned for a message about this year's Nickel War.
Attention all Davis County Panthers. Your peers are in great danger and they need your help. But to help them, they're going to need cash donations during first block and lunch. But you better be quick, because if you don't donate enough money, the Hippopotamus for Christmas song is going to play for the rest of the week. So be fast and raise $3,000 for the epic early release.
Are you interested in business? Do you have an entrepreneurial personality? The Governor's School for Entrepreneurs, or GSE, is now taking applications. GSE is a 3-week summer program held on Northern Kentucky University's campus for selected 9th, 10th, and 11th grade students. Through this experience, students are immersed in a creative space which allows them to bring a business idea to life and present their project to potential investors. Several GSE alumni have started their own small businesses as a result of the program. If you're interested, please refer to your daily email or see Ms. Leisner in guidance for more information.
Now stay tuned for a word from your book.
Yearbook, I already bought it from his head.
Make sure the Grinch doesn't steal your yearbook this holiday season. Go see Ms. Head in room 136. And don't forget, yearbooks go up to $60 after Christmas, so get yours now.
On Saturday, December 8th, DC's own Leland Isbell and Skylar Kane will be performing at the annual Lanham Brothers Jamboree. More information to come.
La 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 la, la la la. Pippin's World. Pippin's World. Pippin's World.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen. I'm back for another week. Thank you to Coach Hall for continuing to allow me to have a segment on the news. That just means a lot to me, and he's a great guy, in case you don't know him. So, the weather outside, everybody, it's frightful. Can you believe it? Today's one of those days where it's a dress-up day leading up to Christmas, and it is about scarves and gloves and all kinds of stuff like that. And I didn't bring those things to dress up. I brought them because I'm freezing outside, and I bet you are too. So I told you last week, I love Christmas time. This is good. And does it look Christmassy or does it look Christmassy? I think it does. So a couple things I've got to talk to you all about. I know the hot question on everybody's mind right now, when am I going to get my exam exemption? It's a really good question. Here's how we're doing it this year. You heard me say it last week. We're changing the way that we are distributing CCR exemptions this year, and I think you're going to be glad that we are, because it's going to take a lot of the confusion out that has existed in the past about whether or not you had your exemption, whether or not you picked up your exemption, whether your advocate still has it, whether you lost it, whether your advocate lost it. All that stuff's going to be out of the picture, because here's what we are doing. We're going to set up in the next couple weeks in the cafeteria during lunch, maybe in the lobby. I don't know the logistics of that yet. And what we're going to do is we're going to have you come up and sign your name when you pick up your exam exemption. Again, I do want to repeat this. Once you get it, you got it. That's it. No more. And then we'll do that again in the spring. So here they are. Here's the list. I'm not going to show you because it's confidential information, but the list of all of my friends right there that are college and career ready based on our ACT benchmarks of an 18, 19, and 20 in English, in math, and in reading, and they're going to get those exam exemptions. If you're one of those people out there who have not met those benchmarks yet, let me encourage you. You should take the ACT again, and you should try to meet those benchmarks. I don't care if you're a freshman. I don't care if you're a sophomore. I don't care if you're a junior, and I don't care if you're a senior. Take that exam again and meet those benchmarks, because I think you're going to be glad that you do, because not only will you get an exam exemption, not only will you be college and career ready based on your academic performance, but I don't know if you remember May of last year, we did something pretty special for our CCR kids, and maybe, old Mr. Pippin's got that in the works again. I'm not ready to make an announcement yet, but maybe something's coming. So, take the ACT. The other thing I got to talk about is today we were originally scheduled to go on our Kids on Campus trip to the University of Kentucky. However, because of the frightful weather that I talked about earlier, we decided to postpone that trip. So UK has been very gracious in rescheduling us, and we are going to be taking that trip on February 4th. So if you're interested in that, let me know. But February 4th seems like a long time away, but I have a feeling we'll snap our fingers and it'll be here. So that's all I got today for you. Of course, it's not all that's going on down here in the CCR Center. You know, there's a lot of stuff going on. So if you need anything, just stop on in and we'll get you taken care of down here in room 116 of the greatest school in the city, in the state, in the country, in the world, and probably the entire universe, Davis County High School. So have a great day, and everybody knows what I say next. What do I say, everybody? I heard it. Go Panthers. Have a great day and go Panthers.
Juniors, are you interested in government? The Henry Clay Center for Statesmanship is taking applications for the High School Student Congress held on Transylvania University's campus for 1 week during the summer. Applications are available in guidance and must be postmarked by February 1st.
Juniors, Kinergy is now accepting applications for the 2019 Washington Youth Tour. This is an all-expense-paid trip to Washington, D.C., where students from across Kentucky visit all of the major monuments. Students must be current 11th graders, live in a house powered by Kinergy, and have at least a 3.0 GPA. Please see Ms. Leiser and guidance for an application and more information. Now stay tuned for a word about this program.
Hi, students. I'm here with Sydney Speed, and we wanted to talk to you, especially juniors, about applying for the Washington Youth Tour. Sydney went this past summer, and she had an excellent experience. Sydney, can you tell them what was your favorite part about attending the Washington Youth Tour?
My favorite part was probably going to see all the monuments in D.C., because I really like all of the monuments, especially the Lincoln Memorial. And other than that, we had an entire day to go through whichever of the museums we wanted to. So it was pretty cool getting to go through all the Smithsonian's, like, on your own time with your friends.
Awesome. Did you make lots of friends?
I did. I made lots of friends while I was there, and we still talk every day, and we try to meet up and hang out, because it's a pretty great bond that you make between people whenever you're traveling in a place without knowing many people.
Good. That's good to hear. Can you tell them about the application process?
Yeah, so the application is really simple. All you have to do is write an essay and email it in, and it's not a very long essay at all, so it's a really simple process.
So if you just did a GSP application, this is going to be a breeze.
Oh yeah, much easier than a GSP application.
So if you're interested in applying for the Washington Youth Tour, the deadline is December 31st. You have to live in Kinergy's area that powers your house. And you can stop by guidance and get an application, and I'd be glad to help you with it. Thank you. Thanks, Sydney.
Here's what's going on today at DC.
The JV boys basketball team will be taking on OHS at 6 p.m.
The JV girls basketball team will also be taking on OHS at 7:15 p.m.
Stay classy, DC!